child predators who photograph their abuse for sale or trade, and the team of investigators who help hunt them down.
Colleen Henry joins us. And Colleen, a task force of cyber sleuths actually trolls the internet to stop child pornographers.
Well, Kath, agents say their work is a cat and mouse game. Tech-savvy porn producers trying to stay one step ahead of the law, and investigators out to stop predators and rescue their child victims.
Sir, do you know who you're looking for here?
In Milwaukee, he was known as Sergeant Phil Wenzel, spokesman for the Milwaukee County Sheriff's Office and respected commander of the patrol division.
We need to keep things safe out here. We need to keep traffic moving.
In cyberspace, Wenzel called himself Country Boy and swapped his homemade child pornography like baseball cards. Quote, girls I have to share range from 6 to 14. Hot little diaper girls, girls this age on cam, or naughty girl self pics to share. You show me yours, I'll show you mine.
This isn't a stereotypical type of person that everybody thinks about. These are your neighbors. These are your friends. These are your family. These individuals are people that are close to your children that you will never know until it's too late unless you keep an eye out for it, I think.
Milwaukee Police Officer Brant Unger and FBI agents Brett Banner and Jason Fleming are cyber sleuths of the Milwaukee Area Innocent Images Task Force. They won't discuss the Wenzel case directly, but court records detail their detective work that unraveled the web spun by Wenzel and his cyber associates. Denver. Agents raided a home and seized a hard drive that led them to San Diego, Kansas City, Pittsburgh, and Milwaukee, a network of the most dangerous of child pornographers, those who groom children, document their sexual exploitation, then pimp their prey in high definition. Ironically, it's rarely the victims who expose their abusers.
Over 90% of our child victims that we've worked with, if they're offended, it's by a known offender. They're not going to report that somebody's offending them because they have a bond with that individual, be it a parent, a coach, teacher, daycare provider.
The Denver bus revealed a face-to-face meeting where Kansas City and San Diego pornographers shared victims and digital images. The San Diego suspect detailed sex shows live streamed from Pittsburgh. The Pittsburgh suspect named a regular customer, Country Boy from Wisconsin, who sent him cash to watch the sexual assault of children via webcam.
And if you want to get into certain groups, you have to prove yourself. You have certain types of child pornography. Like I said, the more hardcore that you can produce buys you more, essentially, street cred.
In breaking up the ring, investigators rescued more than 20 children from ongoing abuse. Country Boy Phil Wenzel pleaded guilty to sexually assaulting 6 sleeping or drugged children, most at a campsite he rented in Fond du Lac County. Wenzel will be sentenced next month. For this trio, it's not a job, it's a mission.
This is our goal. Our goal is to identify children and to rescue children that have been abused.
And that job is getting tougher. Agents say the FBI opened 16,000 child porn cases between 1996 and 2005, a 2,000% increase since the creation of the Innocent Images Task Force. The ease of online swapping, they say, fuels offenders' addictions.
They just honestly can't stop.
The task force warns parents it's critical they communicate with their kids and heed their instincts.
Don't have this idea that it can't be my child, because it can definitely be your child.
Now, all 5 of the members of the Wenzel child porn ring are now in federal custody. When Wenzel is sentenced next month, prosecutors say they will ask the judge to send him to prison for 45 years, Greg.
It's really a situation that just, it turns your stomach. It really does. And you put some more information online on WISN.com to help families.
Yeah, you know, there's some fascinating information, a really intriguing interview about the National Library that catalogs millions of digital images to help identify those kids in those digital pictures, and a primer to help parents protect their children online. And most importantly, there is a link to report child exploitation.